Hey everybody, this is the tutorial for the aging, wrinkled female character, which in this case, I have already, you can see I've already painted in some of the hair and the suit, and I am focusing the video on when I actually start to paint in her features. And you can see I've already blocked out the major light shape and the major shadow shape. And right now I'm just kind of smoothing out edges and getting ready to begin focusing on where those wrinkles are going to be. One thing to remember when you're painting the light over these shapes on the face is that if the light is coming over a curve, like on a cheek, it's going to be a soft transition from the light into the shadow. And if it is creating a cast shadow, and it's kind of going over a hard edge, so like, say the bottom of her lip, the transition from light to dark there is going to be harsher. And so here, even it may look like I am drawing those wrinkles in, but I'm actually erasing the light around the corners of her mouth because it's not going to be able to reach those areas where those folds are. But I'm not drawing anything in with a darker value, I'm just simply erasing where that light is. So I can hear I'm painting in the occlusion shadows, which are the deepest point in each of those crevices, and where the least light is able to get in. It's kind of a way of locking in the features on the face. It's also usually a good idea to find a lot of these deep darks when you're first figuring out the features, because they act as really good anchor points for the rest of what you're going to have to do. When you're painting in a lot of the features, if the person is particularly old, I would stay away from using totally soft round brushes, because the skin gets a lot more of kind of an erratic texture to it, and if you're using a perfectly round, smooth brush, it's more likely to look like very youthful, clear complexion. And make sure, especially on people of advanced age, that you don't go too harsh with the jawline. As the skin sags around the bottom of the face, you tend to lose any hard edges that would be in the jaw. But actually, as a general rule with portraits, I try to avoid getting too sharp with the jawline because it almost always looks wrong and it looks kind of like an action figure head stuck on top of a plastic body. One thing to remember when you're drawing in the occlusion shadows in some of these deeper parts is that you can use the wrinkles to... Actually, you really should be using the wrinkles to define how the shapes on the face are changing and how the planes are all changing directions. So keep in mind plane changes as you're putting in those creases. You can see how a lot of these wrinkles are kind of meant to enforce, or actually reinforce the expression. Because obviously the more often you make an expression, the more often those lines will appear on your face just all the time. And especially if you're doing an expression for a character that is, you know, kind of like their signature expression, then those wrinkles are going to be the deepest wrinkles on their face. So here I am using the smudge tool to actually push and pull the light in areas where the wrinkles are more pronounced. It's a way of kind of smoothly building those shapes in. So again, here you can see I'm using the eraser to build up the forehead wrinkles. One of the benefits of this is, since I have the shadow color beneath the light on her face, I know that when I erase the light away, I'm not going to end up with a value that is too dark. Because you really don't want it to change too much from what's happening on the shadow side of the face. Because that's all you're really seeing, is where there's no light, is you're seeing the shadow side. So now that I'm putting in some of the higher value highlights, this is another really good opportunity to paint around some of the most pronounced areas of the wrinkles, because it will heighten the effect of how deep each crevice is, whereas with some of the lighter wrinkles, like the ones that are on her forehead, and the ones that are kind of up around the top of her eye, they don't really stand out, and you don't have to emphasize those ones. And here you can see, rather than drawing in the lines of the wrinkles, I'm drawing in the highlights that fall between them. So here I've got a color layer and I'm starting to kind of add more saturation to each area, but it's important to point out that you don't necessarily want to add a bunch of color into every painting you do of an elderly person. Sometimes it can add a lot if you actually desaturate the skin and pull a lot of the color out of the cheeks and things like that, but in this case, I do want to give her a more professional appearance, and I'm assuming, I mean, on top of the fact that she's probably got a bit of makeup on, if it's an active, more lively person, they're still going to have a lot of color in their face.